Good evening, guys. Welcome to Satya Technology, your Java class by Venkat Reddy. Guys, is it audible to everyone? Everyone, guys, is it audible? It's fine. Guys, if you want to read values dynamically, which class we have to use in Java? Good. if you want to read integer values, which method we have to use? Fatima, tell me which class name. I already said class name. How to say which class? Guys, which method? If you want to read integer values, which method we have to use? Utpal, do we have any space for next int? Now, if you want to read single character data, how to read single character data in Java? If you want to read single character, how to read single character? Give me the syntax of single character, guys. Everyone? Already I gave the task on Saturday, right? Question me, we don't have any next char. Already I mentioned, right? Good, Srinivas. We don't have any next char method. How to read single character data? Already I gave assignment on Saturday, right? Not Saturday, Friday itself. I gave that one, the task. How to read single character data? No, guys, hardly one or two members gave correct answer. Remaining members not gave the correct answer, guys. Hardly five to six members gave the correct answer. Remaining members, no. So means you didn't try. Try yourself. I won't give you the answer. Try yourself, guys. That is your task only. Fine. Good. Now let us observe here, guys. Now, up to now, what are the programs we did? Once check our programming style, guys. What are the programs we did up to now? All programs are what we did, guys. First, main method. Guys, what we are doing? We have only one method. That method is called main method, right? We are taking only one method. That method is what? Main method, right? Except main method, we never use any other method. Right? Yeah. So not only main method, guys, we have other methods also available. How to use other methods? That concept I'll explain. Already I said clearly how to use other methods. What are the different types of methods we have? What are the different types of variables we have? This concept I'll explain in the time of OOPS concept, guys. Already I mentioned, right? That particular concept I'll explain at the time of OOPS concept. So here, let us observe, guys, here. Now, so up to now, what are the program we did? That program is like this. What? Imagine if we have, a line called, sir, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Imagine I have 12 lines of code is there where inside of main method, guys. Just remember, inside of main method, so I mentioned inside of main method, I mentioned what, guys? 12 lines of code. Okay, imagine. Now, whenever you go for execution, guys, remember, whenever you go for execution, guys, is it all lines are executed or it's 1, 2 lines, 3, 4 skip, 5, 6 lines, 7, 8, 9 are skipped, 10, 11, 12 are executed? Is it all lines are executed or else any lines are skipped? Inside of main method, if you write 12 lines of code, what happened? All lines are executed. How many times? Only one time, right? Only one time all lines are executed. Fine, good. Only one time all lines are executed, means from top to bottom all lines are executed, only one time execution start, all lines are executed. So your program execution starts from main, and whatever the lines we have in main, all the lines are executed, that's it. So up to now, whatever the program we did, that programming is called as an sequential programming. Sequential programming. Means line by line. In main method, execution starts from main method, and the execution starts within main method only, line by line. In main method, line by line. But what is my requirement? My requirement is a little bit different, guys. What is my requirement? Sir, I don't want to execute line by line. I want to control the flow of execution. For example, if you want to control flow of execution, means what? I have a lines like this. 1, 2, 3 lines are available here. And here I have 4 and 5 lines are available. Fourth line. Fifth line is available here. And then I have 6th line. 6th line, 7th line, 8th line, 9, 10, 11, 12. This is my number of lines, guys. Remember, this is my number of lines. Fine. Observe here my flow, execution flow. Observe, guys, everyone. So, first 3 lines, I want to execute as usual. First 3 lines, I want to execute as usual. I don't want to modify. So, 3 lines executed. Now I have a condition, 4, 5, 2 lines are available. Out of these 2 lines, I want to execute only one line. Remember, out of 2 lines, I want to execute what? Only one line. So depends on our requirement, either 4th one or 5th one, your choice. Execute any one. Fourth one or fifth one, your choice, execute only one. So execute fourth, fifth, then continue remaining lines. Otherwise, one more scenario. So observe one more time, what happened? Yes, 1, 2, 3 lines are executed. After executing 3 lines, 4, 5, 2 options are available. For second time, I want to execute fifth one, not fourth one. I want to execute what? Fifth one. Then coming to sixth one, I have to continue myself. How to continue myself? Like, observe here, 4 and 5 is available. In between 4 and 5, I want to exude only one based on my requirement. I don't want to exude both. I want to exude only one based on the requirement. Observe here, two options are available, guys. In these two options, I want to exude only one based on the requirement. Based on the requirement, I want to exude only one. Now, coming to 7 and 8th item, so what I have to do, these 7 and 8th lines, I want to execute multiple times. 7 and 8th items, 8th lines, these two lines, I want to execute multiple times. Not one time, I want to execute multiple times. 2 times, 3 times, 4 times, 4th time. It's all about your requirement, guys. 4th time, 5th time. Like, I want to execute these what multiple times. After executing 7 and 8 multiple times, then what I have to do? Sir, I just want to move on to, I don't want to execute any other thing. I just want to go for what? From here, 8th line. From 8th line, I just want to go to wait, 12th line. I don't want to execute any other thing. Just directly, I want to go for what? 12th line. That's it. From 8th line, I want to go for what? 12th line. I don't want to execute any other things, guys. After executing 7 and 8 multiple times. So what I'm doing, I want to transfer my control. I want to transfer my control from one line to another line. Observe here, requirement. Here we are controlling the flow, right? In previous, we are not controlling the flow, but here we have to control the flow. So this type of execution, observe guys, sequential, no problem, nothing. Happily, you can write the code inside of your, like main method. But here, this is the code which we are writing to control the flow, guys. Here, how to control the flow? We have different options are available in order to control our flow. If you want to execute this one, this is called as an control flow statements. In order to perform that type of operation, we have to use what? Control flow statements. Control flow statements. Let's use what, guys? Control flow statements. In control flow statements, observe what is the first one? What is the purpose of control flow statements? Control flow statements are used to control the flow of execution. Control flow statements are used to control the flow of execution. In order to control the flow, if you're not using control flow statement, yes, it will execute in sequential order. No, I don't want to execute in sequential order. I want to control the flow. If you want to control the flow, go for what? Control flow statements. So control flow statements are classified into three types. Control flow statements are classified into three types. They are, observe what are those? So our main heading is what? Control flow statements. Control flow statements. Our main thing is what? Control flow statement. Under control flow statement, classified three types. First one is called conditional statements. First one is conditional statement. Second one is looping statements. Third one is jumping statements. First one is what, guys? Conditional statement. Second one is what? Looping statements. Third one is what? Third one is what, guys? Your jumping statements. Totally, we have three types. Guys. Fine. So, control flow statements are classified into three categories. Conditional statements, looping statements, and then jumping statements. These are the three types. Classified into three categories. Very good. Observe each and everything. Fine. Now, under control statements, check, guys, under control statement, what we have, sir? Under control statements, we have if, else. If nested, if and then nested if, switch case, if else if nested if, switch case. Coming to looping statements, we have for loop, while loop, do while loop, for each. These four comes under looping statements. Coming to transfer statements, break, continue, return. These three comes under your jumping statements. So this is what, guys, your, your control flow statements. Everyone check all the control flow statement, guys, 2 minutes time. Guys, especially those who are attending Java as well as Python. Sir, both classes are attending some people. For them, in Java, Java control statements are different. Python control statements are different, guys. If anyone attending Java and Python both, stop. First attending Java and Python both. First focus on one thing, either Java or Python, focus one thing. Then only once finish, then only go for either Java. So if you are focusing Java, focus Java. After finishing Java, go for Python. If you're focusing on Python, then first learn Python, then focus on Java, guys. Okay. Because Java syntaxes are different, Python syntaxes are different. Java concepts are different, Python internal concept is different. So that what will happen? Lot of confusion will occur. So here in Python, if, else, elif. But here if, else, if. In Python, we don't have any statement called switch, but here we have a switch. And coming to looping statement, we don't have do while loop in Python. And we don't have for each in Python. And in Python, we have while else, for else, which is not there in the loop, which is not there in Java. In the same in jumping statement, what happened? Break, continue, return, that's it. But coming to in Python, we have assert, we have pass. But interview, if you're attending both the interview, if they're asking what are the jumping statement, Python jumping statement, you will explain to Java. Java jumping statement, you will explain to Python. The syntax is also different, guys. So if you're trying to focus on Java, Python at once, if you are your legs, one leg in Python, one leg in like Java, it's like you kept your two legs in two boats. problem to you guys. So you never remember anything. You never remember anything. So first focus on only one thing. So once you are able to understand, then only move on to second one. Don't focus on two at once. Okay, so first learn one perfectly. First learn one perfectly, then go for another one. It will be good. Okay. So otherwise, Saddam Hussein, that's why you know how our education is. I'm not pointing to your education. You know how our BTech students will be there, right? So, observe. These are called as what, guys? Your control statements. These are called as what, guys? Your control statements. So, guys, remember, sir, in my semester, I have Java is available, Python is available. Both are available in my semester. That's why college studies means college studies only. So, in order to finish your Python, hardly for 50 sessions required. Once 50 sessions is over, then focus on your Java also. Otherwise, you can listen. For me, no problem. If you are sitting, if you are listening, for me, what is the problem? Nothing will happen. For you only. I'm just thinking about yourself. And I'm informing you guys. You decide. Lavanya, understood? So in this one, let us observe. First one is what? Conditional statements, right? Now let us observe conditional statements. Once again, I'm repeating, guys, those who are trying to learn both at once, you'll face some problem while remembering the syntax, everything, and understanding the concept also. It is better first to learn one subject perfectly. After that, learn second. Focus on one subject perfectly, then focus on second one. Then you will get a good knowledge. Then it's up to you, guys. Right, but who said Python there is no openings? Today also an opening comes from Python. Already I posted all my old students. Today also a company, Bangalore company, they are offering 20,000 rupees salary. So they need Python candidates. Already I posted to all my old students. Now they prepared the resumes. They are already forwarded the resumes also. Today only came. Openings are there. For freshers only, openings are there. Because of lockdown period, so what happened? They're not taking the employees more. They hold on all the things. Okay, but surely, definitely, we have a lot of openings once this issue is a little bit reduced. Once we got the response from the company, means government will give the permission, then definitely there is a huge openings, guys. Okay. Library to learn Java, it will take 6 months, 7 months time, right? To learn Python, hardly it will take 2.5 months. That's it. Where 7 months time, where 2.5 months time. It's your choice. So maybe you haven't feel that one. Because as a Python, as a Java developer, both I know, right? That's why I gave the suggestion. You decide. Your choice, guys. I'm not forcing anyone. Your choice. Whatever interests are, I will focus on both. Okay, focus on both. What will happen for me? If you want to attend, nothing will happen for me, right? Your choice. But as a trainer, I have to give the suggestion. That's why I gave the suggestion. If you take the suggestion, fine, good. Otherwise, no. Chodo. Let's continue our class, guys. Fine. So conditional statement. What is the purpose of conditional statement? Observe, guys. When to go for conditional statement means if your requirement is, if you want to execute certain statements, if you want to execute certain statements based on condition, remember guys, if you want to execute certain statements based on condition, then use what, guys? Conditional statements. Remember guys, our requirement is what here? I want to execute certain statements based on the condition. I want to execute certain statements based on the condition. My requirement is what? I want to execute certain statement based on the condition. So if my condition is satisfies, then only I want to execute, sir. Otherwise, I don't want to execute, sir. Then definitely go for what? Conditional statements, sir. In that one, first one is if, right? Now let us observe if. Now let us observe if, what if will do, when to go for if. Yes. Guys, remember, you have only one set of statement. How many set of statements are available? Only one set of statements are available. If we have only one set of statements, if you want to execute only one set of statement, if you want to execute only one set of statement based on condition, then go for what? If. If your requirement is, if you want to execute only one set of statement based on the condition, then go for what? If, guys. Then go for what? If. The general syntax is, observe general syntax, guys. What is the syntax we have? Our syntax is if, open bracket, condition, open curly braces. What are the statements we have? Statement one, statement two. How many statements we have? Write all the statements here, guys. Close the braces. Statement 3. Observe here. If you have, remember guys here, if we have, I have some set of statements are available. So here statement 1, 2 are available, right? These are called as in what? If block. Observe, opening and closing brackets are available, right? That's why it is called as an if block. From opening and closing bracket, they're called as what? If block. If block. So what happens, sir, in if block? In the sense, first control will come to condition. Control will come to condition. Condition means, guys, what type of result will come, guys, whenever you write any condition? Already we discussed it. Conditions always gives what type of results, guys? Condition always gives what type of results? Manikant, value or boolean value? True or false? Conditions always gives boolean type of results, right? Condition means always use boolean. Boolean means what? Either true or false. Only two options, nothing more. It always gives either true or false. Either true or false. In case the condition result is true, remember condition result is true, then your statement 1, 2, all these if block is executed. Remember, in case your condition is true, then all these statement one, statement two, all are executed. After executing all these, control will come to outside. And statement three is executed. And finally, statement three is executed. And then finally, statement three is executed. Control come outside and then statement three is executed. Not like that, guys. Imagine when this one, if condition is true. In case condition is false, observe the flow, guys. Condition is false, then it never execute if block. Directly control comes to statement three. Check. Directly control comes way. Directly control comes to way statement three. So everyone check here, guys. What happened here? So first it checks the condition. Condition means it will return either true or false value. Right? If it returns true value, then if block is executed. Otherwise, your statement three is executed. Only this is called as an if, guys. If condition is true, then only it will execute. Otherwise, it won't executed. Observe an example, guys. What is my requirement? Write a program to check given number is even or not. That's it. So I want to check whether given number is even number or not, guys. My requirement is very simple. I just want to check given number is even number or not. That's it. Nothing great, right? Now let us do the programming, guys, whether it is an even number or not by using what if. Read value dynamically. Then check whether given number is even number or not. You have to display, guys. If it is an even number, so you have to display even number. Otherwise, no need to display any message, guys. If it is even number, then only you have to display. Otherwise, no need to display anything, right? Now. So dynamically, I have to take the value. If you want to read dynamical values, we have to import one class. What is the first line we have to write, guys? If your requirement is, then what is the first line, guys? Everyone tell me, what is the first line we have to write? Import java dot util dot scanner. I don't want all other classes. I just want only scanner class, right? That's why I mentioned import java.util.scanner class. Imported. Then class. My class name is if example one. Very good. What I said, read one value and check whether it is even number or not, right? So if I want to read, I have to create object for which class? Scanner class, right? Scanner sc equal to new scanner of. What I have to write, guys?
System.in.
What I have to write?
System.in.
Who's that? I said only type. Someone is unmuted and speak. Only type message. Yes, very good. Here we have to mention system.in. Fine, good. Now I have to read the when I have to read number, right? That's why system dot out dot print mention what? Enter any number. Enter any number. Fine. Int n equal to se dot next int of. I'm reading that number also. Now let's check if. What is the condition I have to write, guys? Whether it is an even number or not? What is the condition we have to write to check whether given number is even number or not? Everyone? Yes, very good. Very good. So here n value modulus 2 is equal to 0. N value modulus 2 is equal to 0. If it is okay, then only I want to display system dot out dot print ln. What I have to say? Given number is even number, right? Otherwise it is not an even number. Simply I'm writing system dot out dot print ln. Thank you message. That's it. That's it. Program is over, guys. So observe here. If this condition is true, then only 11th line is executed, right? If 9th line is true, 9th line condition is satisfied, then only 11th line is executed. If this condition result is false, in case this condition result is false, then it won't execute it. Simply only thank you message comes. Only thank you message comes. Let's check. Save. If example 1. Now let us open, guys. I will open command prompt. Just a minute, guys. Now check your command prompt. Java C space. If example 1 dot Java. Compile, right? Now execute Java space if example 1. Enter in number 8. 8 is even number, right? Everyone check 8 is even number, right? That's why we are going to get output as even number. Given number is even number. Execute once again. I gave reasons 5. 5 is not even number, so only thank you message will come. So if condition is true, now condition is satisfied, then only it will execute the statement. Otherwise it won't execute the statements. That means yes, here we are executing the statement based on the condition. Based on the condition. Right? This is what, guys, if. So in if statement, what happened? It checks the condition first. If condition is true, then only it will executed. Otherwise it won't executed. If condition is satisfied, then only it will execute. Otherwise it won't executed. That's it. Sir, in case if I give odd number, then it has to display given number is odd number. That is fine. But here if I give odd number, it doesn't display any message. Instead of that, it must say give answer as in thank you, right? No, sir. My requirement is what? Condition is true, I want to execute one type of message, sir. Condition is false, I want to execute another type of message. Condition is true, I want to execute one type of message. Condition is false, I want to execute another type of message. If your requirement is like that, then we have to go for one more thing that is called as an what if else. Go for what if else. Second one is what if else. When to go for if else, sir? Observe when to go for if else. If you want to execute one set of statements, if you want to execute one set of statements out of two set of statements based on condition. Yes, your requirement is what? Your requirement is what? You want to execute only one set. You want to execute only one set of statements. Remember, your requirement is what? You want to execute only one set of statements. Only one set of statements. Not more than that. You want to execute only one set of statements out of two set of statements. I have two set of statements are available. I want to execute only one based on the condition. Then use what if else. Then use what guys? If else. In if else, we should have two set of statements. Sir, I have only one set of statements. Go for if. Only one is available. Go for if. Two are available, then go for what? If else. Fine. Now let us observe the syntax, guys. Now let us observe the syntax here. So what is the syntax here? If condition, if condition is satisfied, then statement one is executed. If you have any other lines, yes, we can write. Else, statement two. Close the braces. Now observe here, guys. If condition is satisfied, statement one has to execute. Else, otherwise, I want to execute what statement two. Observe two set of statements are available. One or two, both two are available. If condition is true, now statement one is executed. Condition is false, then statement two is executed. Of course, here I am writing what statement three. Here I am writing what statement three. Now just observe the flow, guys, everyone. First control comes here. Control comes here. Here this is called what, guys? This is called if block. This is called if block. And this is called what, guys? Else block. Right? Yeah. So first control checks the condition. In case condition is true, then it will execute your statement. Then it will execute your statement. After executing the statement, control will come to where? Your statement three. Guys, statement three out of your if else, right? That's why control comes to outside of the block. In case, sir, condition is false. Condition is false. Then directly comes to where else part. Guys, everyone understand the flow. In else, do we have any condition to check, guys? In else, do we have any condition to check? No, right? We don't have any condition. That's why simply it will exude all the else part. If condition is false, simply it will exude all your else part. After that, from here, control comes outside and executed statement 3. And executed what? Statement 3. That's it. That means observe, guys, here. What is the statement here? On point, observe. In case condition is true, then if block is executed, then control goes outside of if statement, in case condition is false, then else block is executed, then control goes outside of if. Observe the requirement, guys. It's all about your requirement, guys. It's all about your requirement. What is the requirement? You have to decide. In case condition is true, then if block is executed, then control goes outside of if. In case condition is false, then else block is executed, then control goes outside of if. Now, based on this, write the program, guys. Based on this one, write the program. What is the program? Yes. Write a program to read number, then check. Given number is even or odd number. Given number is even or odd number. This is my requirement, guys. Write a program to read number, then check given number is even number or odd number. Guys, here, how many set of statements are available? Dattatreya statement 3 is common statement. That's why always it will execute it. Guys, even number, odd number. How many set of statements we have? Two set of statements are available, right? If you have two set of statements, then go for if I, if else. If or if else. Because I have two set of statements, right? If you have two set of statements, then go for if else. Right? Now, let us do the programming, guys. Here, save as if example 2. Now, same guys, util, scanner, read the number. If n more or less 2 equal 0, given number is even number. Else, otherwise, open and closing bracket, here mention what? System.out.println. Given number is odd number. Given number is what? Odd number. Else part extra added, guys. That's it. Nothing great, right? We're just adding what? Else part. Save. Observe, if condition we are writing, if it is true, yes, even number, else what, odd number, fine, good, save, and then go for compilation, Java C space, if example 2.java, Oh, I think file not saved. If example 2. Yes, okay, save once again. Okay, Java C space if example 2.java. Yes, Java space if example 2. Enter any number. Observe, it is asking enter any number, right? So based on your number, you are going to get even number, odd number. Both will come this time. Check 7. 7 is odd number, right? Even number is odd number. Thank you message. Execute. I'm giving 16. 16 is an even number, right? Even number is an even number. Thank you message. So two set of statements are available. Odd number is one set, even number is one set. But at a time, only one set of statement is going to execute. At a time, only one set of statement is executed. This is called what, guys? Your if else. This is called what, guys? Your if else. Fine, guys. Guys, any questions here? Haven't checked the program? Any questions? And if or if else? Is it clear for everyone, guys? When to go for if and when to go for if else? Think first. Already we learned how to write the conditions at the time of operators. Now apply that conditions here, write the program. Now I'm going to give you the task, guys, everyone. Now itself, you have to do one more program, guys, okay? One more task. Your task is what? Write a program to read here. Write a program to read here. Then check given year is leap year or not. Write a program to read year, then check given year is leap year or not. This is program. Everyone do it, guys, now itself. You have 3 minutes time, guys. Within 3 minutes, finish, then ping the answer. Srinivas, remember one thing here. Here, imagine, in our college, we have two genders are available. One is male, another one is female. Imagine, only two genders are available, not third gender, two only available. You asked one person, are you male? Are you male, you asked. They said that, no. Then are you going to ask, are you female? Condition required or not required? So not required. In case third gender is available, sir, male, female in my college, transgender is also available, sir. Third condition is available, then the scenario is different. Then we'll move on to another one. If else, if one more is available, right? That we have to go. That concept I will explain. Not today, tomorrow I will explain the concept. Today, just observe here. First finish this program. 3 minutes time, guys, for everyone. 3 minutes time, you have to finish within 3 minutes. Everyone, do the program and ping the answers, guys. Do the program, then ping the answer. guys, everyone has to do, guys. Everyone, Ashok, where is your answer, Ashok? I gave the task, right? Now check the answer, guys, whether your answer is correct or not. Check everyone. Same program, guys. What we have to do, sir? Same thing. What we have to do? Yes. Read year. Modulus what? 4. Year modulo division with 4. If year modulo division with 4 is equal to 0, if year modulo division with 4 is equal to 0, given year is leap year. Given year is leap year. All right. Otherwise, given year is not a leap year. Not a leap year. So given year is not a leap year. That's it. What happens are given year is leap year. Otherwise it is not a leap year. That's it. Now save. Example number 3, write, save and go for compilation. Java C space if example 3.java. Java space if example 3. Enter any year, means any number, means year, guys. So 2021 is not a leap year. 2020 is a leap year. So our requirement is what they are asking, what we have to do it. That's it. Enter any year. Check the condition first. Based on the condition, you have to write the code. What is the requirement? Based on the requirement, what we have to do it. Guys, I'm taking what? Very basic level coding. I'm writing what? Very, very basic level coding, not high level coding, guys. Fine. Again, this video will upload it by tomorrow, day after tomorrow. That's why subscribe this channel, guys. Already, guys, all our videos are available in YouTube. Remember, guys, all our videos are available in YouTube. What do you have to do, guys? Just subscribe our channel, open YouTube. Guys, everyone, open YouTube. Then type what, guys? Satya Technology Venkat Reddy. Type Satya Technology Venkat Reddy so that you are going to get all our classes. So that we are going to get all our classes. Okay, here in Satya Technology, just select what? Subscribe option. Subscribe our channel, guys, so that when our videos are updated, immediately we are getting the messages so that you can follow it. Okay, go and subscribe our channel, guys, and share and like. Fine. Just to type Satya Technology Venkat Reddy, you are going to open our videos. Then you can subscribe it, guys. Channel subscribe, you are going to get all the videos, guys. All the videos, whenever any new videos uploaded. So immediately you are going to get that updates, guys. Fine. And your task, guys. Guys, remember in leap year, whenever you are checking what leap year. Okay. Whenever we are taking the leap year. There is one special case is there, guys. Some 400, 1600, some special case is there. At present, don't bother about the special case, guys. At present, don't bother about the special case. Okay. What do you have to do? At present, don't bother about the special case. What do you have to do? Just to focus on what? Basic condition. That's it. Special case means this if else is not sufficient, we have to go for nested if. Still we didn't finish, right? That's why don't worry. Okay. Fine. And guys, most probably if possible this week, otherwise next Monday onwards, we are going to start either this week or next week onwards. We are going to start if possible this Thursday, guys. We are planning to start this Thursday. Okay. Remember, if possible this Thursday, otherwise next Monday onwards, I'm going to start your Core Java advanced topics. This is basics. Core Java are divided into two parts, guys. Core Java is divided into two parts. One is Core Java basics, and then one is called as one Core Java advanced topics. Advanced topics in the sense your hoops concept, inheritance, exception handling, multi-threading, okay, Java IO package, collections, so interfaces, abstract classes, packages, constructors, how different types of variables, different types of methods, how to work with the arrays, how to work with the strings, all these concepts comes under advanced concepts, guys. That concept, that one I'm going to start by either this Thursday I'm going to start, otherwise coming Monday I'm going to start, guys. Okay. Yeah. Your task, just take the task, guys. After that you can ask the questions. First let me give the task to you. Let me give a task to you, then you can ping your questions. Just a minute, guys. Your task, because you have to practice, right? Now your task is first program, guys. First program is write a program to read. Write a program to read 3 subject marks of a student. 3 subject marks of a student. Check whether student is pass or fail. In case student is a pass, then only calculate total and average. Otherwise, display message as better luck next time. Means he has to fail, right? Instead of specify fail message, display on message what? Better luck next time. This is the first one. Second question is, write a program to read 2 numbers, then display biggest number among 2 numbers. Biggest number among 2 numbers. Third one. Write a program to read number, then check whether given number is positive number or not. Write a program to read age of a person, then check whether person is eligible for vote or not. Write a program to read male age and female age. Male age and female age, then check whether they are eligible for marriage or not. Read male age and female age, then check whether they are eligible for marriage or not. Now, write a program to read gender of a person. In case gender is female, means F, then only display message as allowed to book seat. Otherwise, display message as you are not allowed to book seat beside of a female. You are not allowed to book a seat beside of a female. This is the thing which I need, guys. Fine. Everyone check. So this is your task, guys. Everyone, this is 6 programs are your task. Everyone take the screenshot, guys. Everyone take these 6 programs as a screenshot. Take the screenshot. Everyone finished off, guys. Tomorrow I will ask, guys. Tomorrow individually I will ask. Everyone has to give the answer. Remember, tomorrow everyone has to give the answer. Fine? Yes. And once again, guys, one confirmation message. Either this Thursday or Monday, I'm going to start for Java only advanced topic I'm going to start. OOPs concept. So what is OOPs, principles of OOPs, and then different types of variables, different types of methods. But your advanced Java means advanced concepts are not free, guys. It is payment, guys. Advanced concepts are not at all free. It is payment. This concept will go on, guys. 4 to 5, this concept will continue. The basic concept will continue. Along with that one, advanced concepts also going to start. So that concept is payment, guys. I will inform you tomorrow. I will inform by Thursday, guys. Once I will get that everything, then I will inform you guys. Don't worry. So these basics, only basics are free. You can continue the basics, no problem, guys. But once advanced concepts, for that one, payment will be there, guys. Yes, I'll inform you guys. Don't worry, I'll inform you. When once the decision is finalized, when to start, date, everything finalized, then I will inform you guys. Fine? Good. That's it for today, guys, and we'll meet tomorrow, guys. Thank you, guys. Yeah, Fatima, regarding to the fees, we'll inform you later. Once date, everything finalized, then I will inform you guys. Still not yet decided, right? That's why, don't know exactly. I didn't get the complete information. Once I got the complete information, I will share everything, guys. If you have any questions regarding to today topic, you can ping me, guys. If you don't have any questions, you can leave today, guys. But practice, practice is very, very important. Srinivas, 3 subject marks, your choice. You can take any subjects, max, physics, social, or English, science, or some other, or else your BTech subjects. Take any subjects, any 3 subject marks. 100 is a maximum marks. As a programmer, you have to think, analyze. That are same timings, no change, timings never change. Piyush, what is a pass mark in 10th class? That's it. 35 is a pass mark. You have to check 35 pass mark. Marks, not 35%. Krishna, all are basics, right? And previous all classes are available. The recordings are available in YouTube also, right? So that no problem, we can follow it, right? If videos are not there, then problem will come. No, Dattatreya, maximum is 5:40. We'll start by 4:05 and I'm going to wind up by 5:40 or 5:45. That's it. In middle, 5 minutes break also I will give you. Yeah, no problem. For your Selenium class, no problem, Dattatreya. Don't worry. Krishna, all our classes are available. Previous classes are available in YouTube. All our previous classes are available in YouTube. Just type Satya Technology Venkat Reddy so that you are going to get all our previous classes. Once have a look so that you will have some glance idea, because basics, we are not dealing with different advanced concepts also. Because some people don't have any idea about any programming language, right? Because of that, I am taking basics onwards. Some people don't have any idea about any programming language. So if you go to interview, people will ask some programming, logical questions also raised. That's why I will take care of everything, guys. From basic onwards, I will take care. Fine, good. Any other questions, guys? Yeah. So that's it for today, guys, and we'll meet tomorrow, guys. Thank you, guys.